everyone, it's Ali. Thank you so much for joining me today for the second instalment in my Christmas card series 2021. Today we're going to be doing some layered stamping using Distress Oxide inks. While these cards look quite complicated, they're actually really easy to batch make, but I have tons of tips and tricks along the way to help you enjoy making your Christmas cards this year. Let's get started. For these cards I'm going to make today, I'm going to use the Jolly Gingerbread layered stamp set from Crafter's Companion. This is a set of three stamps that layer up to make a scene. Last time I looked on the Crafter's Companion website, this was actually on special offer because it's from last year. So if you want to go and check it out, I think you can get it for about £6, which is really fantastic for a set of three photopolymer stamps. I'm going to use my Tim Holtz stamp positioner for my stamping today, just because it means I can stamp over and over again in the same place. And it will make it a little bit easier if you're doing batch card making. And I'm also going to use Distress Oxides. The first colour I'm going to use on the first layer of the stamp, they are all labelled with the number, is brushed corduroy distress oxide. I'm going to stamp that twice just so I get a really good even coverage of my initial image. I've got a tool that I use, my stamp positioner, to make sure I get a really even pressure across my tool. A lot of people always ask me about this tool, and you could find similar ones on places like Etsy. Just look for stamping pressure tool. My friend Gareth actually made this one for me, so I can't give you a link to where this one is from. I've done my two layers of my brushed corduroy, and now I'm going to flip my piece of cardstock round and do the same again on the other side. I may as well, because it's going to stamp in exactly the same place on both sides. And now I'm going to do my second layer, which this time I'm going to stamp in Candied Apple. This is number two of the stamp set. I'm just taking my time to really make sure that my stamp is in the right place. Because there's a lot of detail on this stamp, there's a lot of places you can check whether it's in the right spot. So it did actually make it really easy to line up. But my advice would be just take your time, make sure you're looking at it from above, look at every place on the stamp where it could line up and make sure that it's in the right place. I actually found these really easy to line up. I think it's because the amount of detail on the stamp, and also because they're not super, super detailed. So if you're, you know, a little tiny bit out, it's not going to matter. I've done that on both sides of my cardstock now, and then I'm going to do the final layer. This time I'm going to stamp in Ground Espresso Distress ink. I think the combination of brushed corduroy, candied apple and ground espresso went really, really nicely. I was looking through my stash to find just the right colours that matched their image on the front of the packaging. And these were not quite there, but I think with the combination of the cream cardstock, I think they look really, really nice. You could, of course, pick all kinds of different colours to do your gingerbread in. You don't have to do them in traditional gingerbread colours. You don't have to use red. You could use green instead. But this is how the stamping came out. I think it looks absolutely gorgeous, especially with how quick it was. And you could repeat this again and again on a bunch of different pieces of cardstock and make loads of backgrounds. I'm going to use this vintage Christmas stamp set for my sentiments for these cards. I've picked two different sentiment stamps from this set, and then I'm going to heat emboss them onto vellum. So again, I'm using my stamp positioning tool, and I'm just going to stamp them using Versamark ink onto my vellum. This is quite heavyweight vellum, so it's less likely to warp when I heat emboss it, but you can use most kinds of vellum. I decided to use vellum rather than cardstock because I really didn't want to cover up any of that pattern when I added it to the front of my card. So I've just stamped that onto there, and then I'm going to coat it with some Wow Embossing Opaque Vanilla White embossing powder. I used this on my previous videos and I really, really like it. It's not quite white, it's got a kind of creamy vanilla tint, and It's just something a little bit different and really nice. So I've just put that onto my vellum, and I've kind of flicked it to allow any loose pieces of embossing powder to just, you know, fly off, because I didn't want them on there. And I'm going to heat that using my heat tool from both sides. The embossing powder sets really, really fast on vellum because of the medium is so thin. Just make sure to keep your heat tool moving to minimize warping when you're melting your embossing powder. Now we're ready to assemble our cards, so I'm just going to cut these backgrounds down. I'm going to cut them both differently. So one of them I'm going to cut with a small border at the edge, just to kind of mimic a mat, and then one of them I'm going to cut right up to the edge of the stamping. This is just to show that you can create different looks. So I could have added an additional cream mat behind my cardstock, but it was kind of already there for me, so I just trimmed it to leave the mat around the image. And now we can add our sentiments. Yeah, I told you these were easy cards. I'm just going to trim my vellum sentiments down. I'm leaving them really long because I'm going to wrap the ends round behind the card front, just so I don't have any like messy glue sticking through my vellum, which is not a look I tend to go for on my cards, to be quite honest with you. Wrapping the edges of anything made of vellum behind the card, I think, elevates the card a little bit more. So I've just trimmed those down and now I'm going to attach them to my card. I'm just deciding where I want it on the card or where I want my sentiment. And then I'm going to use my ACG gun to add a bit of adhesive on the back and then just flip over the end pieces of vellum and stick them on the back of the card. And that's the card front done. So I'm just going to repeat that on the second card front, just exactly the same way. I've put it in a different place this time just because why not? Let's mix it up. Those are my two card fronts done. And then just to finish off these cards, I am going to add a matte on both of them. I've chosen a darker brown just to match the darker ground espresso that we used in the stamping. And I'm going to attach these with a very, very small matte. I think this is like 1/16th of an inch around the edge of the card fronts. And then again, I'm going to use my ATG gun to attach these to my card bases. I've made these card bases to be the exact size I needed them, just out of craft cardstock. So they fit nicely, but obviously I still made it the wrong size, so I had to trim it down. But that is my first card finished. That is the one without the cream mat that we've left built in. And then this second one is the one where I have cut the card panel with a cream board around the edge to look like a faux mat. It adds a little bit extra to the card, so you can obviously go for whichever one you prefer. You can mix it up. I like to make different cards even if they're on the same theme, so that's my kind of thing. I don't like to make the same card twice. So there is our other one with a slightly larger sentiment. I'm really pleased with these. I think they look really lovely. I think you can make a whole set of these either in different colors or the same colors with different sentiments, and as you saw, they were really, really easy to do. I hope you enjoyed this video and you learned something new. I'll link all of the products that I use in the description box, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see future episodes in my Christmas card series. Thanks so much for everybody who's been hanging out on my channel with me today, and I hope to see you back here again soon. Bye.